It is a sight you normally don't see to this extent. Heavy machinery covered in white from limestone, a project so large it took more than 15 to 20 trucks a day hauling waste out, limestone in, day after day for 2 years.
It's being applied at a rate of 3,600 tons per acre, which would make that the largest application of alkaline addition on any AML site in the nation.
Coal mining in Huling Branch goes back to the 1800s, and later in post-war strip and underground mines. It is also home to the problems associated with those. High walls totaling more than a mile in length, 100 plus acres of spoil and waste coal, and danger to nearby ATV riders. In some cases, riders fell into abandoned pits and nearly lost their lives. Acid mine drainage also threatened one of Pennsylvania's best trout fishing areas.
They're very sensitive streams. A little bit of acid wipes out the whole stream system. And these little streams combine into the big streams, which is the West Branch, the Kettle Creek watershed in the West Branch, which has been historically dead for, you know, probably close to 100 years from past mining activities.
Success did not come easily. Pennsylvania tried for years to fix the problems at Huling Branch. After considering several means to funding, the state chose to go the AML route, getting federal money and enlisting nonprofits to find matching funds, totaling more than $12 million. It even squeezed money out of the polluted ground.
We are getting a small credit for the coal as it's being removed from the site, which is going back into the offset, the overall cost of the project. And the refuse material is being removed and taken to a cogen facility where it can also be utilized to generate electricity.
On site, even more difficulties. Crews had to deal with the presence of poisonous snakes that are also a protected species. And bitter winter cold also slowed the project.
This site did have significant hazard.
But real economic value will come over time from returning the land to productive use. The ATV trail will get an expansion to attract new riders, and more will come for fishing and camping, which the state says generates a big return per day.
You come all the way from Beaver Falls.
Yeah.
How far away is that?
Oh, it's approximately 190 miles.
So that's a pretty good drive.
South, southwest.
How much do you suppose you spend to catch one fish?
Oh, I wouldn't have any idea. I know we spend more than what we catch, but it's the fun of it.
The project is already showing results, with fish returning to previously acid-filled waters, and motorcycle racers return to the trail for a championship-level race in 2017.